Hey, we are here at Resd in Birmingham. We're here with the producers of Enola. Do you want to introduce yourselves, guys?
Yes, my name is Balbina Lagas, and I am a developer for Enola.
Okay.
And my name is Sergio. I am the game director and writer. Well, one of the writers, at least.
One of the writers.
Yes.
Cool. So can you guys talk us through a little bit about what Enola is about, the game?
Yeah, Enola is a psychological horror game that's a very story-driven game. No monsters, no killing. It's more about puzzles and a very, very deep and interesting story.
Is it similar to the likes of games such as Outlast or Amnesia, for example, because they're really popular at the moment?
Yes, it has some elements of several games, but actually they're all really hooked up as to make a very different game and experience.
Oh, wonderful. I mean, you're saying about you being a writer, What sort of inspired the story for you?
Well, the game is very Silent Hill inspired from a visual point of view, but the story is pretty much a recollection of ideas from different places.
Yeah.
It's a very personal story, not as in personal experiences, but as in personal to one of the main characters. The story is about this, you play as this girl named Enola, of course.
Yeah.
And the idea is that one day you get back home and you see that your girlfriend is missing. It's a two-girl couple that has been together for many years already. And when she's missing, well, actually she leaves the house and leaves a lot of stuff for you to see. And you decide to go out and look for her. And while you're looking for her, you start to learn some information about her that you didn't know. And it's about learning all her backstory and
exploring her past kind of thing.
Yes, exactly.
Cool.
So it's the thing is that it's like in real life when you are in a couple and maybe you're not very comfortable with sharing everything that's inside you. The same happens here. Angelica, who's the girlfriend, has some many things inside of her mind and inside of her heart that she cannot share. She feels ashamed or something like that, for example. And it's your job, so to speak, to learn all that stuff.
Oh, I see. Well, that is, like you say, it is psychological. Are there less sort of monsters, ghouls, and zombies or anything like that? Is it mainly just about the dark, kind of the creepy side of someone's psyche? Is that mainly the story? What are the jump scares like? What's kind of scary about it?
Yeah, the scary is more of the environment, the music. There's a couple of jump scares in the game.
I like jump scares.
Yeah.
I'm a complete wuss.
Yeah. But mainly it's about having an engagement with a person, trying to find more about what's really happening. And the more you get into it, the more you're gonna find interested in finding all of these.
Right? So how can people get their hands on Enola? When are we expecting a release date?
Well, we plan to release on summer on Steam, but you can actually get it now on the Sura and Gamers Gate and other smaller sites. And right now we are alpha funding the game, so it's 33% off while it's in development. And right now during the show we actually have a 40% discount if you use the Humble widget, and they will send you our current build. We update the build every now and then, so to show that we keep working on it.
Yeah.
And you will get a Steam key from them when the game is released on Steam.
Okay, well, I love a good psychological horror, and like I say, at the moment, like games like Amnesia and Outlast are really kind of big on trend. First-person sort of like survival horror is really becoming a big thing, so I can't wait. I'm really excited. Last thing, favorite game ever?
Final Fantasy VII.
Yes! Sorry, I got so excited then, literally. That is my favorite game ever as well, so high five for that.
Excellent.
That is the best thing. What about you? What have you said now? It's never going to match up to that.
Silent Hill from 1 to 3.
Yes, the best Silent Hills. They're not as good as the new ones, really, are they? Yeah, they're not quite as scary as the old ones used to be. Thank you so much for talking to me, boys, and TV out.